It's the dawning of the 20th century. The major powers of Europe are in the process of divvying up the last fragments of the world map among themselves. At long last, the German Empire wants a place where it can bask in the limelight too. It sees its chance along the Bosporus, where temperamental Sultan Abdulhamid II rules over a vast territory. Time for the Germans to secure the biggest infrastructure project in all of Asia Minor. The legendary Orient. The kingdom of 1001 nights. Where milk and honey flow. The Baghdad Railway is the key to the Orient. It will give the German Empire access to valuable resources. The railroad project is going to be financed by Deutsche Bank, a German bank. You're supposed to make sure that nothing fishy goes on site. A railroad from Baghdad to Istanbul, brought into being via sound German engineering skill. A bold venture. As long as the project doesn't make a profit, the Sultan has offered to offset any losses with his tax revenues. Needless to say, one is only too glad to help local agriculture increase its earnings. Make sure that grain production develops beneficially. At the same time, it guarantees funding for the Baghdad Railway. Thanks to your logistics support, food production is soon going to gain momentum. Your legendary fellow countryman, Karaben Nemzi, crosses your path. What a splendid coincidence. Accompany the fearless adventurer and stand by him with advice and support. Oh, no. Sir David Lindsay, your countryman's English traveling companion, has caught the dreaded Aleppo Evil. A horrible sore is running riot on his already sizable nose. A desert herb is said to cure it, but the plant can only be found at very specific altitudes. The Henry rifle and the double-barreled bear killer have disappeared. Track down Karaben Nemzi's precious weapons and bring them back. Holy moly! Your faithful companion Hadji Halef Omar was taken captive by a savage desert tribe. Rescue him! Thank you. Thanks to your help with the grain harvest, the Sultan is collecting a tidy sum in taxes. And those taxes, in turn, guarantee that you'll be paid. Now the most challenging part of the route lies before you. The Taurus Mountains block the way to Aleppo like the jagged back of some primeval monster. But you've overcome every obstacle so far. Many hands will be needed to conquer this compact but rugged mountain range. The best thing would be to hire enough people on both sides of the mountains. What an adventure. Kara Ben Nemzi Effendi is deeply indebted to you for your services. Work in the mountains is only progressing slowly. Access to the Mediterranean would prove to be extremely useful. A branch line already runs from the port town of Mersin to Adana. It would be advisable to buy it up. Instead of begging for credit from your superiors, you might as well purchase the line all by yourself. That will certainly make an impression back home. You ought to pitch camp on the other side of the Taurus at the branch line's last stop. Silver has been found in the mountains. This enables you to finance the branch line to the sea using existing funds. Your superiors in Germany will be seriously impressed. Wonderful. The silver mine is yielding enough to buy the branch line. The Sultan's civil servants are a nuisance. No matter how small the request, each time they expect a favor in return. For instance, for assuring that none of your merchandise disappears. The other nuisance are the Brits. They constantly snoop around near the oil drilling sites. You ought to sick a couple of savage desert tribes on them. That'll keep them busy. Whether Bedouin tribes or civil servants, they all have one thing in common. Put enough silver in their hands and they're very cooperative. All your wishes will come true. Traces of an ancient civilization can be found in the desert. Word has it that fabulous treasures of untold value lie waiting there. Set off to recover them before others beat you to it. A British archaeologist has already set out to search for the ancient stone fragments from Carchemish. Beat her to it and find the city of ruins in the desert. The remnants of an ancient settlement. Maybe even the cradle of civilization. Who knows what kinds of valuable artifacts lie slumbering beneath this pile of rubble and ruins. Despite all the digging, no artifacts can be found. Maybe the British lady was faster in the end. On the other hand, the excavation crew struck an oil well that's gushing away for all it's worth nearby. That's not bad either. Now that the civil servants and Brits are occupied, you can devote yourself to more important things. There are vast amounts of crude oil in the desert. This stuff makes it possible to drive an automobile, a newfangled recent invention from a fellow German. But the fact is, the new rulers of the Ottoman Empire are pretty shady figures. So get moving and secure access to the oil fields. Then organize transport for the oil. The more machines, the quicker the pace. And that goes for completing the Baghdad Railway and for extracting crude oil. And the quicker the better. Things are slowly getting creepy. The necessary machines have arrived. The Baghdad Railway can finally be completed. Time to quickly pump out a few more tankfuls of oil and then get out of here. Delight the Sultan with an exclusive Pullman car so that he continues to view your project favorably. Naturally, the car's interior requires a special decor, tailored precisely to His Majesty's needs. The Sultan prefers to rest on a purple divan couch. They say chances are good to find one in Aleppo. A delicate porcelain tea set is essential. The car is supposed to be furnished with this in Adana. There's something missing without an exceptional carpet. The most magnificent carpets are knotted in Konya. What a sumptuous Pullman car. It would almost be worthy of the German Emperor. That may be, but unfortunately, the Sultan doesn't have the slightest interest in traveling by train. He prefers a sedan chair. The engineering marvel has been completed. But you're so homesick it hurts. See to it that you hurry back to Germany.